Well, what's the matter with you? What do you think you're doing? Now, come on. What about a do? I'll wave around, and then you see if you can help me.
Ah, but gee, Mr. Ruff, I don't want to hurt you.
You hurt me? What are you talking about? You couldn't hurt a battleship. Come on, now. Get busy. Come on. Oh, gee, Mr. Ruff. I didn't mean to.
Would you like to try a little more, Mr. Ruff?
That's enough. Come here, get busy with him.
Attaboy, come on now. Show it, Ham. Show it. Get away from
me. One of an 8-piece slaughter.
Danny Ruff, Danny.
How are you, Pete? I'm glad to see you. I want you to meet my new fighter, Ham Hand McShelly. How are you?
How do you do?
All right, love. Slip it out of here, Tony. Well, 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 Pete. Where have you been since you left the Bury?
Oh, terrible.
Why, what's the matter?
Why, I made $1 million in oil.
Oh, and you're sore at that. I'd hate to see if you made $2 million.
Well, you know I got married, and the wife's gone high hat, and all they've had is social functions.
Why don't you come over and visit the old gang once in a while?
I can't. She's giving one tomorrow afternoon. Say, why don't you come over and help me take it on the chin?
Sure. I'll bring Ham Hand.
Good.
He's used to taking it on the chin. See?
By the way, the wife's invited everybody in the Blue Book. She doesn't know half of them. Here's a couple of invitations. You come as Mr. Montmorency, and you come as Percival Fontaine.
Mr. Ruff, can I take Stale Annie?
No, Ham.
Please let me take
no
Stale.
I'll be...
Please! No!
I'll be expecting you tomorrow afternoon now. Don't fail me.
I won't, Pete. I won't.
All right, boys.
So long.
Goodbye.
So long, Pete.
Goodbye.
Look, Mr. Ruff, ain't she sweet? For the last time, no. But it says here, Mr. and Mrs. Read it.
Hey, come here. Open this door here. What's the matter?
It's rented.
Let him alone, will you? I had a tough enough time getting him into it.
You would. Come on, come on. Now, you make yourself at home.
Sure, thank you very much.
Mr. and Mrs. Fontaine. Mr. Montmorency.
Mr. Fontaine!
How do you do? How do you do?
How do you do? Mr. Fontaine.
Oh, Mr. Fontaine! Oh, Mr. Fontaine, let me introduce you to the chair.
Oh, I'd love to be there.
Boy, you did great. You fooled her completely.
Mr. and Mrs. Smith,
meet Mr. Montmorency.
Very pleased to meet you.
How are you enjoying yourself?
Oh, huge.
Now, everything that you want, just make him walk stone and the boy will bring it to you. Good time,
I beg your pardon.
Mrs. Billingsgate, meet Mr. Montmorency and Mr. Fontaine.
Pleased to meet you.
Pleased to meet you.
Well, how do you do? Won't you sit
down with me.
Much obliged.
I'll be back in a moment.
Don't hurry.
Well, scram, lug, and find yourself a place to hide.
I beg your pardon.
Just a great thing, boy.
They will play, won't they?
Oh, yes.
I say, Mrs. Billingsgate, didn't we meet at the Ritz?
Well, hardly. But I've seen you and that fighter of yours at the stadium every Friday night. And let me tell you something. As long as you let that ham battle away, he does, he'll continue to kiss Rosalind.
Huh?
Stop letting him lead with his chin.
Sit down.
Annie.
Yeah?
Let's play that old slugging game.
Oh, swell.
How many lumps, madame?
Two, your highness.
Four. Ah, look out. That's a rented suit. Hey, where's the knife?
Use your fingers.
It ain't polite.
Now bite.
Pull that. Pull that. Now I'm gonna knock this guy on his back.
Oh, no,
now, wait
a minute.
Shut up!
I'll kill him! Excuse me, Gertie, whatever.
I'll kill him!
I'll be right back.
I'll kill him!
No, Hammy!
These men are not Mr. Montmorency, nor Mr. Fontaine. He is nothing but a cheap prize fight manager, and that's his fighter.
Say, what do you mean a cheap fighter? Why,
wait a minute. Keep out of this.
Is this true?
Yes, it's true. What do you want to make out of it?
Well, I shall ask you to leave the premises immediately.
That's okay by us. But let me tell you, it'll do you people a world of good if you was to take a peek at a good brawl once in a while.
Wait a minute. Why not hold the ball here, right now?
Swear.
I'll kill him!
You'll get your chance. What do you say?
I should love to take him on for a few kicks.
Fine. Come on in the parlor while we get more room.
I'll knock his ears.
Jay, are you going to let them have this prize fight in my house?
Yes.
Oh.
I'm going to have a fight, a box fight. That's what it is.
Well, certainly. You got any boxing gloves? Good, get them. I want this joint cleared out of here. I want the table pulled back against the walls.
I'll knock them over.
Shut up.
Ladies, start your man.
Dear friends, in a meeting of this sort, it is usual to pay admission. So, in place of this, we will take up a little collection. The hat will be passed, and in that way, we'll get the judge. Winner take all, and I'm the referee. What?
Now listen, straight markers are Queensbury rules. Understand? No hitting on the chin, no hitting below the belt, and the following punches is barred. The rabbit punch, the kidney punch, the corkscrew, and the pivot. and no hitting between the chin and the belt.
I'll kill him!
Shut up.
I'll kill him!
Shut up. Watch the gate.
$3 and two IOUs.
I'll fight him for nothing. Shut up.
Make them quite snug, please, sir. Just feel comfortable, Mr. Watson. Quite all right, Thomas.
Is that too tight?
No, sir.
I'll kill him!
Shut up.
Dinner is served, madame.
Ah, foot. Where's the kitchen?
Oh, sit down.
Oh, no, no. I'll cut it one. Listen.
What do I cut it? Pardon me, sir.
Yes, Watson, with pleasure. So I admit, I said to those men, I said, be careful when you're on the 2 seconds.
Listen, you know, the idea is to get out there and hit him.
How can you hit him when he won't stand still?
Don't argue with me. Shut up and do like I tell you.
Idea.
Let go of it.
Time.
Allow me, sir.
Pleasure, Watson. Thank you.
Come on.
three, four, five, and five is 10, you're out.